We all must die one day. It's natural. It's what happens to humans. Birth, life, death. None of these events are mutually exclusive. However, there is a stark difference between natural death and murder. Furthermore, there is a very big difference between murder and state complicity in the murder of innocent, unsuspecting people who were just trying to get to the safety and comforts of their homes from all the chaos outside. China is flooded. Central China is under water. But floods are normal. Floods happen all the time. People die in them too, unfortunately. However, countries do not lie about the death figures of such natural calamities. And then, the floods of China are not even natural, they are man-made. On top of it all, China is lying about its flood-related death toll. The Chinese people are livid, and they are about to land one huge kick on the bottom of the CCP. Hi and welcome, this is TFI Global, the foreign affairs and geopolitical analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I am your host, Sanbir Anhotra, and in this video, I will tell you why the CCP's reign is not going to last long, now that it has been caught red-handed trying to discount the severity of the ravaging floods. Let's begin. Right now, if there is a hell, it would be a better place for the people of China to be in than China itself. China has surpassed what can be considered a hellhole. It has transcended all levels of possibly tormenting its citizens. China's crazy drive for building dams is what has begun costing thousands of people their lives. Central China is flooded. The official death toll of the ongoing floods has risen to 56. However, many believe that thousands are dead already and that the CCP is doing what it does best, fudge data and hide the reality from Chinese citizens, not to mention from the world. China's Hainan province is inundated. Cities are practically underwater. A city of 10 million people has faced the most frightening rain spell in history. Metros, roads, buildings, they are all flooded. The Zhengzhou city in the central province of Hainan in China relocated more than around 200,000 people after the torrential rains led to widespread flooding. China is blasting its ill-built dams so as to save the lives of millions of people. Essentially, all hell has broken loose in China. There is a flurry of videos on social media which expose how the Chinese people are suffering. According to a social media user, Jennifer Zeng, who has been at the forefront of reporting the reality of floods in China, within a single tunnel in China's Zhengzhou, thousands of people seem to have died because the toll-collecting machine would not let cars pass through without paying the fee. Slow internet connectivity led to traffic to pile up along the entire six-lane tunnel while it was flooding simultaneously. In the end, the entire tunnel was filled with water, leading to the alleged deaths of everyone inside. Those who died in such a manner, trapped and alone, knowing they were not going to be saved, were seen sending money to their relatives and loved ones. Meanwhile, the CCP has been engaging in a show of bravado and applauding the rescue efforts being undertaken in the flood-affected regions. It would serve China good, however, to just admit how many people died in the floods. Yet, it is lying right through its teeth. China is not new to lying. In fact, it has perfected the art of lying. China's propaganda blitzkrieg can be matched only by the lies spread by the Nazi regime and Hitler's propaganda minister, Joseph Goebbels. China will never admit the real number of casualties caused due to the ongoing floods. Hell, China is a country which does not even admit its soldiers' deaths when they are killed in action battling Indian troops in the Himalayas. To even think of China admitting the deaths of ordinary Chinese citizens would be a silly proposition. The Chinese people have lost their family members in the raging floods. Mothers have lost sons, daughters have lost fathers, parents have lost children, and children have lost their parents. The Chinese people have, essentially, lost all hope. Their lives are now so cheap that their deaths too are not recognized in China under the CCP's tyrannical rule. Make no mistake, the average Chinese citizen has been seething with rage for quite a long time now. The CCP's brutalities are hardly unknown to the Chinese people. Hyperinflation, no freedoms and rights, a continuous subjugation by the Chinese state, institutionalized supremacy of the Han Chinese, shortage of electricity and water, ballooning debts, a crumbling financial system, and much more have contributed to the Chinese people viewing the CCP in their hearts as a hostile force. They might not be very vocal about it right now, because if they are, that's the last anybody would see or hear of them. So, almost strategically, the Chinese citizens are waiting for the CCP to cross the red line. The floods can very well prove to be the last straw for the Chinese public, which will rise in a magnitude which will not only shock the CCP, but will also force its pesky comrades to run as far as they can with their tails between their legs.